Hi guys, welcome back to my War of the Vision video. Now I'm gonna review Gafgarian, so let's talk about his stats first. So I compare him to Zugeld and Shadowlings because I think they have exactly same role for your party, and Stern here as just show you that UR character stats are much better than MR characters. So when you have max all of his level and abilities board, he has 240 base attack stats, which is the highest on the comparison chart for MR characters. It is possible for Shadowlings to surpass him though, because Shadowlings has 20% attack. The point here is he is not like Atree, who is really bad, okay, in terms of stats. Another good thing about Gafgarian is his luck stats. His base luck stats may be lower than Shadowlings, but after you have unlocked all of his boards, you have 201 luck stats. If you are wondering about luck stats, it affects evasion and accuracy. So yes, it is quite important. Now, critical rate. He has the best critical hit rate boost of all these characters. You can see that Gafgarian has even better critical stats than Stern, who is a UR character. So yes, amazing. This high critical rate synergizes well with his master ability. Let me show you his master ability. So his master ability gonna deal 25% critical damage. So that means if you have high critical rate, this will trigger more often. And yes, Stern also has the same master ability. So yes, I must say it is pretty amazing for MR characters to have a little bit better master ability, because this will give you plus 10 AP on battle. So yeah, pretty nice, I must say, okay? And the bad thing about Gafgarian is, wow, his health is pretty low, only 1227 when max, about 15% lower than other MR characters like Zugeld and Shadowlings. His agility is also not that high, okay, but I think it is still acceptable. And another thing I hate is his range, I mean movement range, because he only can move 3 tiles and have 1 jump stats. So combined with that mediocre agility, he will have hard time to move on stages where there are many high terrains. It is different case for Stern, because Stern has ninja and dragoon subjobs. So Stern has access to support abilities which can increase his movement and jumping range. Okay, and another bad thing about Gafgarian is his attack type resistance. He only strong against slash attack, so it's quite good against slash attack. He has 25% resistance. Okay, but the bad news is for his magic and pierce attack. Okay, so most characters only have 1 attack type resist, so having 2 type attack resist is kind of big downfall. That's my opinion. If you feel strange why resistance is so bad, this is because I equip one of his support abilities. I will talk about that soon. Okay, so let's talk about the job and the best setup for him. So Gafgarian main job is Fell Knight. So this Fell Knight, I must say it is pretty decent. Okay, so this first one, Abyssal Blade, this is the strongest skill that he has, but the trademark skill he has, I think it is this Shadow Blade, because yeah, if you play Final Fantasy Tactics, you should know this skill. This will absorb damage dealt, so it is like drain for Black Mage. It is really special because his strongest skill, this Abyssal Blade, use his health when you use it. So like you know, he is kinda weak, okay? So that means if you already use this, you want to recover his health again by using that Shadow Blade. So the combination is really good, guys. Really, because both of these abilities are on your main Fel Knight, you cannot go wrong with this, okay? Really good. For subclass job, you want to equip Fel Knight or Warrior. Fel Knight is good because there is Unholy Sacrifice. So this Unholy Sacrifice is good, okay? And yes, it's also dangerous because it also use your health, and if you take a look on the range, it is very close and your party may get hit when you use this. So yes, I don't think it is that good. Okay, but still, it is powerful attack. But to place Gavgarion in the middle of lots of enemies, that's kind of suicide. And this, well, let me show you. Traitor's Blade is also decent because it always trigger critical hit when you attack the enemy from behind, which is something that you want always to do, okay? Attack the enemy from behind to get better damage. And yes, if you trigger critical hit, you will also trigger his master ability. So that's pretty good. But if you think that Unholy Sacrifice is bad and you think you also have quite high critical rate, you may want to use his Warrior, because his Warrior is also pretty decent, I must say, okay? Warrior has Killer Blade. Killer Blade also deals large damage, and yes, you don't use your health when you use this Killer Blade, so I must say this is really good. Okay, especially this also give you Man-Eater, so you don't need to use Deception to get Man-Eater. And most enemies on this game are human. PvP, story mode, okay? So pretty decent. So the worst is Monk. Monk is really bad, guys, because yeah, was one of the best of Monk skills is this Surge Strike. This is ranged attack, but he already has range attack, this crushing blow, and you learn it immediately when you use Gavgarion. So why do you need to wait for Surge Strike? Also, Monk doesn't have large damaging skill. Terra Slash, they are nice, but yes, I don't think it is not for Gavgarion. Okay, so leave Monk job alone. So for support ability, the first support ability I want to talk is this Self-Sacrifice. This is the reason why you see that my Gavgarion has minus 45% on magic. Okay, because this raises your attack greatly. So let me remove this. Okay, remove. See? He lose about 49 attack boost. So that's a lot, guys. So yes, you get massive attack boost, but you also get minus 20% on all resistance type. This will be dangerous when you fight lots of mages. So yeah, I think it's worth the price. The only time you shouldn't equip this is if your Gavgarion dies within one hit. So in that case, change that ability with health up, okay, from Monk. And next ability you want to equip is this, okay? Attack up, because there is no consequences by equip consequence you get from equipping attack up. So yes, I think these two are the best support abilities for him. For reaction, I think this is the best, okay? Nephis Mercenary, because all of his reaction abilities are counter attack, but this counter will also absorb damage dealt, and because it has the wider range than other counter, so this one is the best reaction for him. Okay, so that's all for the job. Now let's talk about vision card. Vision card is really important, guys, when you build the character. And for UR card, you can equip Scion of House Beowulf, Okay, but that's pretty rare. Okay, that's that Ramza vision card is insane. That's one of the best vision card on this game, but not many players gonna have that. So yes, let's just ignore that. But if you have that, congratulations, because it increased slash attack, which is good for Gafgarian. For mega rare, I must say this Iron Giant vision card is quite good because it gives you slash attack plus 5. It also grants your party slash attack resist, which is also useful for Gafgarian glass cannon trait. Okay, but in my opinion, the best card for him is the card from SR rarity. So first card I want to tell you is this bomb. This bomb is really good, guys, because this will increase his critical hit rate, which means yes, that he will trigger that critical damage plus 25% more often. So if you don't have bomb, maybe you have this fun time. This also give your critical hit rate plus 7. The party ability is also maybe more useful because this increase your attack plus 7%, not niche like bomb card. So yeah, these two cards are really good for Gafgarian. And if you equip these two cards, you may want to equip Cactuar on other characters, because this Cactuar will boost your party critical hit rate. Okay, so this card is one of the best SR vision card, that's my opinion. Okay, and this also increase Gafgarian agility, I mean the equip character agility by 4%. I don't recommend you to equip this on Gafgarian. Okay, I recommend this to equip on other character who you use with Gafgarian, because the Cactuar card reduce your defense by 4. You don't want to make your Gafgarian become more glass cannon. Okay, and the next one is this one is good, guys. Okay, because it increase your dexterity, the dexterity affect your critical hit rate. So having higher dexterity will also mean higher critical rate, and this luck plus 5% also affect other characters. Okay, so yes, pretty good card. Okay, and maybe the next candidate is Glutinous King. This one, yes, this one. Okay, Glutinous King. The problem with this is it reduce your agility. So Gafgarian is already slow to begin with, so I don't think this is that good. Okay, but still can be candidate for you if you don't have other SR characters. Okay, now let's talk about the Trust Master reward you obtain from him. So his Trust Master reward, I must say, it is pretty decent. Okay, it is a sword with 120 to attack. If you compare it to Nagnarok, yes, it has lower attack than Nagnarok assault type. But the good point is this also give you 5 critical stats. So again, a good sword for Stern or Gafgarian, because you want to trigger that master ability as frequently as possible. Okay, so yeah, there's nothing wrong with this sword, very good. So yes, get it, guys, really good. But unless maybe you already have 6 plus 5 Nagnarok, but grinding equipment on this game is really crazy, so I won't recommend that to you. So for conclusion, okay, Gafgarian is really good character, the best melee free character you can get on this game. His stats are decent, unlike Atri. He is also able to deal tons of damage easily as long as you have a tank to draw enemies' attack. His glass cannon trait won't affect you so much because you have tank to protect, especially if your tank have that vision card which increase his hate. Okay, the only drawback for Gafgarian is he is dark elemental character. So there are so many competition for dark element. For UR characters, there are Ziza and Stern. For mega rare, there are Shadow Lynx and Ryuryu. So if you already have raised one of those mentioned characters, you may have run out Dark Awakening Prism or Fragment of Thought. And I can say, if you have Stern, it is better to focus on your Stern, because yes, he is more powerful than Gafgarian. Okay, and yes, even if you have Stern, if you already max his, I mean Stern Awakening level, you can still max Gafgarian to obtain the Trustmaster. It is good for Stern, okay, like I have said before. Okay, so yes, he is totally worth the price you used to max him. Really good character. So yeah, but I think that's all you need to know about Gafgarian. Thank you very much for watching. Please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more War of the Vision video. Bye bye guys.